Since I was little, I've always had this really strong urge to be a voice for Mother Nature and try and protect everything that has always given me the most joy in life. My love for nature has kind of always been evolving through my whole life.
Hi, Mommy.
I am so proud of you.
And so it started out when I was a kid, you know, travel around in the van. I grew up living and spending almost all my time outside. And my favorite thing was when I would find a crystal, finding feathers, or seeing wild animals. I think the animals were what first made me kind of want to protect them, because I'd see bears getting in the trash and I was like, oh, I want to be a voice for them. Like, they're the coolest thing that I've ever seen. As I've gotten older, then it was like, okay, well, I'm going to go to school because I want to go into environmental studies. Fast track, skiing happens, I start filming with TGR, it's all awesome. What I really started to see with skiing is earlier, shorter winters and how that affects the snowpack and having more avalanches there. It's just all changing so much, and all of a sudden my care for the environment intersected with climate change, which I didn't really plan on or foresee.
Wow! Look at it, like, you can see all the air bubbles and stuff.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Like, how cool is planet Earth that there's places like this?
One of the conundrums of being a professional athlete is traveling on airplanes all the time and driving snowmobiles and, you know, having a truck. And immediately I was like, oh my gosh, I'm turning into the monster that I always never wanted to be. I really had to take an honest look at myself and an honest look at society. And what I realized is we all live in a fossil fuel-based society. It starts with being okay with that and accepting it and really being motivated to try and find a better way and to voice like what you care about and what you want to protect and how can I do that. It's not always about conquering all the problems and doing everything you can all at once. It's just about doing the next thing that you feel like you can do to give back or to protect it. I have started getting more involved politically. I never called or wrote my senators, ever. I was like, they don't listen to that stuff, they don't read it, like it gets chucked in the trash, you know? But when I started lobbying and we would be like, what's the biggest thing we can do to help you guys? And they were like, we really need to hear from you. And I got that response time after time after time after time. And so I finally was like, okay, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, I'd like to leave a message for Senator Orrin Hatch, please.
Super easy, quick Google search, 1 to 2 minute phone call and that's it. I really couldn't believe that I'd waited so long to do it. You know, habits are hard to make, but that's one I would recommend. Each stage of my life has been this progression of like trying to be more involved. I think a lot of us really struggle for ways to contribute and ways to have a purpose. And so finding Protect Our Winters and finding a way to use my voice to kind of maybe unite this community that's trying to find a sustainable way to make our lifestyles work and protect the things we care about is really what's ultimately satisfying.